Hello and bye Paiva. This is Hearts of Iron 4 and we are back playing Democratic Finland. So in the previous episode we kinda had a mini World War II, I guess. We fought against Germany and managed to defeat them, and so it's broken up into, well, Germany is in three different parts: a democratic part, a communist part, and a fascist part, because the German Reich and Hitler are still around. We were able to liberate Austria and Czechoslovakia and the Slovak Republic. So we still have Italy around, who was in its own faction, and I guess they are fighting. Yeah, they're fighting the Allies. Now, I was thinking that we could have fought against them, but I guess, well, we were too quick in releasing Austria, because now they won't let us back into their country. We can't really get a onto a border of Italy, because pretty much nobody else is willing to give us military access. Plus, well, we claimed Ostprussen for ourselves. No, what is in there? Well, a couple civilian factories. We could give it up to Poland to create a new Poland. We have been trying to work on Latvia, but I think we're competing with, Soviet Union might go after that. We also had the disconcerting, thing that the... Soviets have cancelled their non-aggression pact, so I'm a bit concerned that they may try to attack us, but we're moving all of our armies back, so we'll probably set up our defensive line again. Got one of our armies here against Leningrad. I'll actually just give them a little plan that they can work on. Okay, and then one idea I had was actually to try to trigger a coup in Russia. They do start with a little bit of democracy support, so I was thinking of boosting the popularity. Now, we are doing a lot of other stuff. We can, I guess, cancel that, just so we aren't losing political power. Yeah. Okay, so we're back to me. Well, 0.5 a day. Okay, so, yeah, and there's a little bit of the Soviet Union, and in Catalonia, we liberated Aragon into Spain. It's the state of Spain. Well, democratic Spain. But the rest was Republican Spain that the Soviets liberated. So, oh yeah, we do have a little bit of here. I've been trying to give them a control of state. Okay. You can only give control of states when you're in a war. Alright. Okay, so... we'll unpause it. And see what happens from here. I wonder if Italy will be... make any headway against France. Probably not. Pretty much lost their African territory. I'm sure if Bulgaria is gonna help out. Basically, it's... We have... Okay. We have the Comintern. And then Novus Imperium Romanum. Oh, Turkey is joined. Okay. And then we have our Scandinavian Defensive Alliance. Would be nice if we got a couple others, but... Ouch. Oh, they're all neutral. I'm imagining this is probably because the main war is... Oh yeah, the one remaining member of the Midzi Mordzi. I guess we could. You know, might as well. We're not going to be defending that. And okay. Okay, there we go. We got Company 2, so... might as well get our better field hospital. We need to rescue. So, huh, it's interesting. Poland doesn't have their faction anymore. Oh well. Oh, Poland joined the Allies. Okay. Sorry, Belgium. You're left with the Midzi Mordzi. Oh, who are you with? Oh, you're Axis. Okay. Oh, what happened? Oh, okay, the German Reich got kind of split up. Okay, yeah, British Raj. Australia, yes. Interesting. Don't want these guys to flip fascists. We're trying to make them, push them towards democracy. They're all Comintern. So, how many... Okay, so they have 300 at most. I was able, as Czechoslovakia, to fight the Russians with 10-to-1 odds, so if we have to go to war with Russia, as long as we get our troops back, shouldn't be too much of a problem. Okay, the Marine Saulnier, MS Parasol, Count Erich von Rosen, gifted to Finland, was the beginning of our air force. We should remember his gift as we develop our air force to protect our skies. Okay, so I believe that's a French plane. The Marine Saulnier is a French company. Okay, so we get more on air doctrine. Now, we could... I think we actually have most of these fighters researched, so... I think I'll do the bomber. Do-it-ism? Do-hate-ism? So we can quickly get some of that researched. How is our production? Yeah. Is he trying to crank out? Oh, anti-tank, okay. Did we upgrade our artillery? Yes, we did. Yeah, we need much more military factories. Build up a couple more civilian factories. Okay, so Poland's back. I just figured I wasn't going to be able to hold this territory anyways against the communists, so might as well liberate it to Poland. Kind of thought they might be still in the Midzi Mordzi, but the Allies are just as good. Oh wow! They just... How did they annex Latvia there? Okay, we got our anti-tank improvements. Which is certainly welcome, because Germany had a lot of tanks, so I imagine Russia was... Okay, where are you guys? Okay, come on, try to get over here. Use the railroads! Here's my paratroopers. Did I ever build more of those? Okay, have all the manpower, just no guns to give them. So we could have a look at the wars in the world. Italian-British War. Wow, Italy's lost almost 4 million men. And sheesh. Not a lot to show for it. That's pretty rough. Italy, Japan, and China are slugging it out. Okay, so at least we got our troops back. Okay, let's pause it. Oh, did we? Okay. Okay, let's reset our defensive plan here. We'll put 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven onto here. It's not gonna be as important as that. Okay, so you guys are moving into position. Do you have time to build any more forts? Well, we got decent forts. Try to improve that to level. It only takes a couple of weeks to build a fort, so, well, at max efficiency. Aha, so I knew this would happen. October. Okay, so we have a few months. We can build up our defenses there. Centralized fire control, so it gives us a bit more soft attack. Oh, fighter veteran initiative. Okay, so better plane. So now, these aren't mutually exclusive, so we can actually get this air superiority bonus. And then this one will give us better recon company. Okay, so where's our planes? We have our we have all of our guys here. Move them back here. Have them working in there. Oh yeah, the bombers we accidentally made. Well, we might as well put them in there. Have them working on there. We don't care if they get shot down. Okay. Now, where are our paratroopers? They're here. So, we can try to do a daring paradrop somewhere. Okay, so hopefully we can get most of that built by the time. And as before, we're going to leave the north undefended. Hopefully our allies will come. This is interesting. I wonder if it'll draw the rest of the Comintern in. We'll have to keep an eye on that. Of course, look at all these Russian troops. Okay, we're starting to work on some more. Okay, we're getting our guns back. Still need more support equipment. Take one off of there. Two a day. So that's less than 100 days. Want to keep building more fighters. Probably. probably need more of those. Where can we get steel from now that we're gonna lose it from, okay, hopefully with the war done, it's more friends. And we get more. Okay. It'd be nice if somebody joined us. Oh yeah, neutral form. Should we just give this over? Don't wanna think that it's gonna... Would be cool if we had an army in there, we could push it to Germany, but... Okay, so you're gonna have an offensive plan. Cut off there that border. If our allies fill that in, then this will be basically the shortest front that we can make. And we'll have to see how it goes from there. Oh boy, Joseph Stalin questioned the motives of the Republic of Finland. Well, Germany saved us the previous time, but, we'll have to see how we can do this. Okay. Aircraft provide the destructive power of artillery many miles beyond the front line. If we can develop our tactical and strategic bombers, we will be able to destroy our enemy's ability to fight from the front line to their factories and homes. This is bonus to research some bombers. And now... Oh, we get three military factories. Alright. What are we doing on our forts? Oh, jeez, we lost the... Okay, we don't care about boats, so we don't need steel for that. I just wanted the steel for the artillery. Now we're making two a day instead of, what was it, less than one a day? Okay, so we need more support equipment, more fighters, we need more trucks. Calls 8 to finish workers. Oh, come on. Merits can their convictions hold if they must force them on us. Okay, so hopefully you guys will come help me. How's your military? 33 worse than ours. Wow, the Norway is bigger military than Sweden. That's weird. Oh, yeah. Denmark kind of sucks. Okay. So, we're going to be counting on Norway to come help us out, hopefully. But, hopefully we can push to Leningrad. That'll be nice to take that and defend on the river there. The world learned nothing from the Great War. Okay, so they'll have West Germany and Hungary, well, and Yugoslavia, but hopefully, they'll be distracted. Oh, and they're fighting Turkey, so, haha, might have a chance here. Okay, we got, Ground Attack Veteran Initiative. Alright. Don't need either of those. It'd be nice to get down to here, but let's see. 42. Okay, let's start working on our bombers. Start trying to stage a coup. I wonder where. Somewhere where we can try to support them. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we're gonna have to drop something else. Okay. Oh, they're actually working here. What else are we doing here? Stage coup, boosting ideology. Okay, so that's about it. Got our better field hospital. Now if we just need the tanks, or the trucks to prove it. You guys called in? Yeah, but you're not doing anything against Bulgaria. Oh, we could. I don't know why, though. Oh, they're already... Oh, they're in the allies. Damn, we missed our chance. Oh, well. Okay, so we got, our level 4 forts. Oh, darn it, this one. Oh well. What is this? Okay, we need this one to be built first. Okay, well, you can stand to lose that as long as we have forts here. They have a lot of troops, at least down here, so... Okay, what can we do here? What will help us? Political power gain? That's about it. So let's do that, if we're going to be doing a lot more... So now we are getting... Well... 0.55. It's not a lot, but... better than we did. We used to just have 0.25, so now we're at 0.55. So. Okay, yeah, it actually doesn't look like they have a whole lot of troops here. It's probably spread all about. Okay, so Karhumaki brothers have been instrumental in the development of Finnish aviation. However, the needs of our military have meant we need every last piece of industrial capacity available to us. Thankfully, the patriotic brothers have agreed to cooperate with us, so get 3 more military factories. Thanks to that. Okay, so... Oh, I'm better. Okay. Well, I guess having extra 100 planes would help, if they are a bit outdated, but... Probably would have been nice to get that earlier on. It's not, okay, so... How much longer here? October 1st. Now, quite possibly, they could just, renege on that. They did before. Our commanders are feeling quite happy about it. Probably not building very much. Yeah, look at that. It's like 0.03 per day. Still. Okay. Let's 10% of the way there. Man, that's gonna take a while. Okay, got that, but we can get to the Junkers 88. Pretty quick. Got our factories. So, it'll only take 10 weeks. Okay. Let's see what they do. Just bluffing again. So, it'll allow us to build up our military a little bit more. Probably will, before too long, declare war on the Soviets. So we got to remove the threat of them once and for all. Oh, so the Allies are landing in Turkey. We definitely want to attack Russia before we deal with the Italians. Okay, got our better infantry stuff, so yeah, might as well finish that off. And we can, just when we're about to fully replenish all of our stocks, we got to, oh jeez, and then we're gonna be out of steel again, aren't we? Oh my goodness. Well, okay. Try to get that finished off. Can even try to attack them in winter, because even though we'll suffer a penalty, since we got a lot of our like winter attrition bonuses, we'll have less of a penalty than they will, so. Of course, I'd have to be justifying it now, wouldn't I? Well, okay, a fifth of the way there. So what, I'd say it's about 10% per month, maybe? At least that way, if we go in to help them, you'd have a justification. I'm a bit worried that if we do an offensive war against Russia, our allies won't be willing to come in. So how is there? Okay, now that they're, let's see, they're not losing a lot. Oh geez, they have up to 500 divisions. Okay, got the Junkers. What else can we do now? Well, it's still a bit early for those. We had some, yeah, we can get some electronic research done. Still, well, you know, we have four, okay. That getting that decryption bonus will certainly help. How long will it be this good? Will this be good for? I guess it won't tell us. It's usually a couple of months. See how our coup's doing? Oh, it's a quarter of the way there, so it's making progress. Hey, we got our foreign imports. As much as it would be preferable to produce all our aircraft needs domestically, must accept we do not yet have the capacity to fill our Air Force's needs, and as such, we'll have to sacrifice some of our pride for foreign models and parts. Thankfully, this will reduce the cost of domestic production as well. So basically, we get, we outsource some of our manufacturing to other countries, making it a little bit cheaper. Okay, so let's actually... Oh, darn it. Oh, we have to be in a faction. Okay, so we can't pick those. Air doctrines, ski troopers... I think that's about it. Oh, we have our navy. Okay. Oh, we get some manpower from that. Okay, so actually, we'll just get, we don't really need speeches. Okay, we'll get Doctrine. Doctrine is always helpful. It's better than not having it. China, so eventually they'll probably get that civil war triggered off. Nobody else is interested in joining our faction. Well, they would if they hadn't already joined the Allies. You're in the Allies, you're in the Mitsumorti. You're in the Allies. You're in the Allies. Yeah, looks like they're finally pushing into Bulgaria. Did a landing there. Was that Russians? Canada. You know, Allies, you could just sit back and let the Russians deal with that. Oh, wow. There's hardly any Russian troops on our border anymore. About maybe 10% a month, so well, let's crank it up to speed 5. I'm surprised Italy's holding on as well as it is. Usually it gets some landing here. Better engineering company, so we can always use. Oh, wait, let's, I guess we'll have to wait. Yeah, so yeah, let's keep working on our support battalions. Oh, yeah. They're really pushing into Bulgaria now. Probably won't be too long until they capitulate. Don't trust this, it's gonna change. Yeah, that's still quite a bit. Forward observers! So, you know, yeah, recon benefits. And so this will increase recovery rate and organization and gets us a really good. Tactic because it reduces, or no, wait. Oh, it reduces our damage that we do, but it really reduces the attacker's damage and makes it, the combat with less, so less people can be in the combat at once, which is good for us. So, for having, you know, a small population, this tactic is really nice. Okay, and then this last one, oh yeah. Just better attack for everybody, so. We'll try to finish those off. Yeah, Turkey is going down hard now. I don't know if I want to wait till the summer and that coup triggers off. There goes Bulgaria. Oh, we're at 40. Yeah. Well, we'll give it a try. Okay, our efforts to develop the Air Force naturally create experience and aid the development of aerial doctrine. Okay. So, we just gotta go down our naval. Oh, we built the convoys too. That'll be nice. How many divisions does Italy have, anyways? Oh, a couple hundred maybe. Yugoslavia is pretty strong. Not really. They'll start going down, probably. Okay, got our computing machine. Then we can start working on... That this is more expensive, so we'll grab that. Use the research bonuses for the more expensive techs, so you get a little bit more of a bonus. Probably just equals out to a few days, but might as well. Okay, we actually stocked up on fighters. Do we have any other airports? Support weapons. Okay, so let's get some decryption here. Oh, yeah, okay, there we go. We can have our fighter ace. What does he do? Air attack, max speed, and better agility. Transports? We don't have to do that. I don't think we'll ever need more than 50. There we go. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Can actually probably drop that down. Yeah, we need more of these things. One more, two more, one more. Okay. Halfway there. So we start, yeah, it'll probably be about August maybe. Oh, what the heck? Oh no. Fall of Rome. Okay, there we go. Yeah, you guys are missing a lot of stuff. We want to get more equipment into this staged coup. So. Spain joined the Allies. Alright. Liberia, join the Allies. Okay, come on. Yeesh. Okay, let's just, cancel all of those. Republic of Guatemala, join the Allies. How come nobody wants to join me? So, oh, there we go. was it, 50 a day, pretty much? And we're given over to it? Yeah. Okay, let's drop down a little bit of fighters. We want to be producing maximum number of weapons for this coup. So hopefully the Soviet Union has pretty crummy equipment. Okay, so let's go for trade protection. Yeah, then we can get cruisers. That's probably submarines. How's this coup doing? 60%. Should have made it right in Leningrad. I'm not sure how big. Hopefully it'll be more expanded than just the one territory. But I haven't done coups all that much, so it's a bit hard to say. Okay. Let's get working on radars. Rebuilding. Okay, so let's actually just cancel. Supports. Probably won't be needing them. Our computing machine can do better encryption. Give us a bit of a bonus against Russia. Okay, yeah, so they've pretty much taken over Bulgaria. Oh yeah, SFR is with Comintern, not Italy, so yeah. Against a big block of communists here. Turkey has gone down. Oh, Uga's. Oh, okay, that's probably just some Italian troops left. So the Allies got southern Turkey. Turkey has capitulated again. Up to 72. Because if we can get them to join our alliance, then we'll have a reason to go to war. Okay, so what could we do here? Oh, part. Ah. Oh, we aren't at war. Oh, darn it. What else? We don't need a tank designer. Oh well, might as well just stock it up. Could do, yeah. Wow. Cheaper everything, but really short range. Okay, might as well pick that. Okay, cooperation with Bofors. Okay, so just a couple more months. Better decryption. Encryption. It's even cheaper. Oh yeah, Italy's going down. Okay, so we actually get an election. Democratic parties in minority. Politics in the Republic of Finland have grown increasingly radicalized. There was once broad support. Oh, I haven't been keeping up on that. Okay, well, we'll lose political power just to keep it more democratic. Oh, are you in? Oh, okay, well, I guess we could have gone and had a little bit of fascism, but oh well. Oh, damn! Oh well, hopefully it'll just be delayed and not canceled. Okay, good. Oh, yeah. stop the boost ideology for a little bit, at least. Get us out of the negatives for a while. Usually I don't think too much about losing political power, because, you know, oh, what am I going to use it for? But yeah, if I'm busy trying to influence other people, definitely want to keep it positive. Well, looks like Italy is going to go down pretty quick. Then it'll just be the Soviets, and us, and the Allies, and Japan. Oh yeah, Japan was in their own faction, so... Okay, so we're almost out. So we can hopefully continue our staging of the coup. Radar detection. Okay. Do that. And it's a fire base, so we'll get this last one, which will boost up our attack for everything. Okay, then we can popularity again. Okay, so let's you don't want the Russians to know that we're coming. Okay, so where are we at? Yeah, we lost a couple months. Cooperate with Bofors. The Swedish have decades of experience with weapons manufacturing and their company Bofors. If we were to cooperate with the company, we would be able to improve the firepower of new cruiser designs considerably. Oh wow, okay. So we're gonna get lots of cruiser bonuses. Operation Regatta, get more manpower. Will certainly help. Now what? From where? If it was just a temporary thing. We're missing a whole lot of steel, probably for our ships. Which I'm not terribly concerned about. Oh, artillery. I'm more concerned about that then. And, we should be researching better anti-tank, but... Okay, let's get some more steel. Okay, get a little bit better encryption. So now start. Oh, actually. Probably haven't. Yeah, okay, wow. Fallen behind our industrial stuff. There we go. Yeah, we're down to 5. Here, what. Okay, so if we can grab the steel here, that'll certainly have us sitting pretty there. Not a whole lot until we get down to Moscow. A lot of it is in the south here. Poland and Poland. Well, Poland doesn't have all that much. Mostly in Germany. Of course, we'll probably have to be fighting their puppets. Ugh. That's gonna be rough. These guys can generate a lot of units. How many? Oh, not yet. It's okay. Italy is capitulated. Okay, so... Alright, so at least, Oh, no, went, communist. They're gonna justify a war goal against us again. And... Oh, France took some of it. Okay, so how is our coup going? 92. And I think we've got it pretty well supplied. So hopefully it'll be kind of successful. Last long enough for us to hopefully call it into our alliance. Because that'll be nice. Or if they join the Allies, that would probably be even better. Uh-oh. Looks like they've been bringing more troops here along here. It's not good. Operation Regatta. The Åland Isles pose a serious risk to Finland's defenses against a naval invasion. Not sure why, though. We must secure them, even though they are a demilitarized zone. Our national defense is more important than an aging document the enemy is ignoring anyways. Oh, sorry, Åland. Got militarized. Not even sure if it'll have much effect, because especially with Sweden in our alliance, we don't have to worry too much about the Baltics. Oh, wow. Yeah, they definitely love a lot of troops here. Okay. Get our production efficiency up as high as it can. Oh boy. Okay, so we got a few more paratroopers we can add in. Haha! Republic of Finland succeeded to stage a coup in the Soviet Union. Fires of revolution now burns. Holy smokes, look at that. Okay, so we want to try to... Look at that, wow. Darn it. Well... Okay, so we're gonna try to... We just want Onaga. And we're masked. There we go. Oh, darn it. Okay, we don't care too much about Murmansk. Okay. Not how well you'll do then. Thought it would only take a little while. Okay, lend lease. Okay, what can we send them? A bunch of anti-tank. How much did we have? 600, so yeah. Huh. You only have 20? Oh, what? Weird. Give them half of our production. Well, 40%. And for production of trucks. Oh, I guess we could have given them some planes, but they won't. Send three divisions. Oh man, that's not gonna last very long, is it? Come on, guys. Well, it's getting up there. Not really. Okay. How'd they get all these troops here? Okay, just... last a little bit longer, guys. We're coming. Oh, wow. Oh. Ugh. Come on, I just gotta get to 70. Oh man. Well, it certainly pulled troops off of our border. Man, yeah, 65. I don't know if it's like 1 point per week or something. Okay, expand the shipyards. I don't want to fortify. Okay, we'll go for ski troops. And it's in the winter, so. Declared war on Afghanistan. Oh, what? Okay, no. Okay, good. Okay, they joined the Allies. Darn it. I wanted to have them join us. Oh well. So. Venezuela. Where is ours? April. Okay, darn it. They got there just a slightly ahead of us. Okay, so why don't you call in the Allies? So it looks like they've kind of, stemmed the assault. I wonder if... Oh, wow. Turned democratic. Allies at war with anybody? Oh, yeah. Soviet war on Afghanistan. There you go. Yeah, it looks like they're ignoring the Russian Federation for now. Probably focused more in the south. Angered by Soviet posturing. Just a couple more months. Looks like they're even expanding. Wow. So what is... Oh, geez, they're 50%, So yeah, we can get in there. March. Oh, okay. Italian Union is communist. That's why France is going in there. Okay, got our best computers. Let's get some better decryptions. So we can check what those tricksy Russians are up to. Well, Afghanistan's almost down, but then, oh, no. Yeah, they got up to India, but, India should give them a run for their money. Oh, yeah. Well, so much for Poland. Oh, no. Russian Federation is going down, too. One more month. Just hold out a little bit more. Then we can give Schleswig-Holstein over to Denmark. Shock and awe. There we go. We got all of our land doctrines done. Yeah, it's 44, so let's get our better planes researched. weekly line production, that'll certainly help. 43, so there we go. I just have to build a couple more factories. I don't know what... the mod might have created a couple new territories here, so... Okay. It's almost time, guys. Italian Union has capitulated. Finish our ski troopers. The snow will make it impossible for large numbers of men and vehicles to move by anything less than well-paved roads. If we are to utilize multi-tactics to their fullest extent, we must provide our troops with the equipment and training to travel cross-country quickly. So, we get a little bit of help with mountain infantry. And... Well, we only have two more, so might as well fortify the islands. Okay... Just a couple more weeks. Hold on, Federation. Hopefully that reduced a lot of their... No, there's still a few hundred. Oh, jeez. Soviet Union's as bad as Germany, I guess. What's going on here? And then we'll just have to hope that you guys come in. I can try to do a call to arms. Hopefully they realize what a threat the Soviet Union is. Oh, darn. Capitulated. That sucks. Republican Spain has capitulated. Okay, so here we go. Declare war. What? Oh, Italian Union, okay. Libyan Socialist Republic. People's Democratic Republic of Ethiopia. Okay, we can move over to a war economy now. And planes with no mission. Oh yeah, so... Ugh. There we go. Okay, please join in. What? Oh, I figured. This is an offensive war. They don't want to, Damn. Sure. Oh, thanks. Okay, well, it looks like we're on our own. We'll see if we can, try to cut these guys off. Oh, come on, Norway. Nope. Okay, it looks like we quickly grab... Leningrad. Okay, we're just going to delete this one. Just hold there. Holy smokes. Okay. So we took Leningrad. Making some progress this way. For Poland. But the problem is... enough troops to move up this way. Darn it, I wish we could have, try to liberate the... Ooh, 9 divisions for Americans. That's good. Okay. Just want to slow this down a little bit more. So we can extend the defensive line a little bit. Okay. Because if we can link up with these troops from... geez. Oh, okay. Request Swedish assistance in war. Finland and the Soviet Union are at war. After only a few decades of sovereignty, we now risk once again becoming a subject of one of our neighbors. Threat of our enemy extends beyond our borders. However, our neighbors in Sweden are still retaining a neutral stance towards the Soviet Union, but could perhaps be convinced to join us in defending our mutual legacy and secure their own strategic buffer. Yes, we need your help. Okay. So hopefully we'll be able to hold there. If we can get our defensive line there. Oh, there's the Americans. Or some of them, at least. Oh, come on! Way to go, Sweden. Thanks a lot. Little bugger. Okay. Well, I think we're gonna have to... Okay, cancel those guys. Just gonna need regular troops. No, cancel all of them. We'll try making a new army. I could actually try dropping you guys down here. Aha! East Germany has capitulated. Suck it, commies. Okay. Once you repair drop from here to there. Just a quick little hop. Yeah. Put you all together. Oh. Oh, we've been building! Oh well. Okay, just do a boy rating, just in case they're trying to get some troops. Okay, we got a little bulge here. Let's try to push over. It'd be nice if we could liberate Estonia and stuff. We're still making some progress here. How about you guys try to... If we could, and then just extend our borders around there. Okay, there are troops. Go. Awfully close. Okay, yeah, we don't need the fallback line anymore. Well, we probably do, but... No, we're not gonna forget this, Sweden. No, they don't like it. See, democracies don't like offensive wars. Just want to see how long this has been going. Oh, okay. Well, I guess I'll have to end the episode here. There's our construction, just in case we got any. Okay, so, well, some interesting things happened. We got a decent coup going, but, we weren't able to get them into our faction. And because of that, we had to declare war on Russia. And because of that... I wonder if I could give them... Oh, damn it. June 6th. Oh, I wonder. Well, they'll probably deny it anyways. Okay, so, we are... Well, attacking Russia. We have some help from the Americans. At least they're holding our northern border there. So if we can link up with them, that'll help out. We're making some inroads into the north here. We can try to link up with whatever maybe remains of the Russian Federation. The Allies are attacking Russia because Russia made the mistake of attacking down in southern Asia or in the Middle East. So, it's going to be basically me and the Allies against the Soviets. So, but that'll have to wait till next episode. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I hope you'll join me next time for when we hopefully claim some Soviet Russia. So, I guess I'll just like to say thank you and goodbye.